Hey, what's up, YouTube? Balder here, and I am in the A-10C once again. This is the third mission of the Enemy Within campaign. And this one's going to be interesting, because if you recall, I was kind of annoyed at how long the mission was. Now, if I was annoyed at that, I'm in for quite a welcoming surprise. Because this mission has me circle the entire circumference of Georgia as a patrol. And if anything happens, then I will answer the call, and then I will pretty much, you know, take action. I guess that's all I can really say, so without further ado, I'm going to taxi. Also, I realized I taxied to the wrong runway, which is, it's alright. This is an attack jet. It's perfectly capable of taking off in a tailwind. Let's go ahead, spool things up, get the landing lights going, and full throttle. Not going to take off, is he? I guess I'm doing this by myself. Oh well. I know the commanding officer said that I needed to have a flight of two, but sometimes you have to make exceptions to the rule. Now, I could just restart this and then further lower my score again, but I'm not exactly sure if that's a good idea. By the way, something I actually noticed and didn't notice before. If you look at this TAD, you'll notice that it's using a VFR sectional chart. Pilots of all shapes and sizes use the VFR charts, and it's actually pretty easy to understand once you get the hang of it, such as this little thing right here indicates that there is a tall object that can obstruct your flight path. In this case, it's most likely a radio tower. And then you have other things. I mean, these are power lines, these are trains, these are roads, those are bridges. This 5 degrees east indicates the magnetic variation, so if you have a heading indicator, it's 5 degrees off of true heading as opposed to magnetic heading. Now, just a fun little fact. Also, I'm gonna bring my flaps up. Alright, so another thing that I need to mention is that the last flight path was, I don't know the best way to put it, a little dangerous. Because somebody had the bright idea to take these planes, these military aircraft, at a low altitude, and as a result, I got shot at and could have died. In this mission, this is not going to be the case. I'm cleared to fly above 12,000 feet above sea level in reality, what I'm going to do is that I'm going to climb up to 20,000 feet, then I'm going to hit the autopilot, and then I'm going to go from there as my cruising altitude. The reason I'm doing that is because once I have that nice cruising altitude, the air is going to be thinner, and therefore it's going to be much more fuel efficient. If you ever go on the 104th or see videos of the 104th, and somebody in their fighter jet is low on fuel, they will climb at a higher altitude. Yes, it takes fuel to get to that higher altitude, but at the same time, you're going to be burning a lot less in the long run, which is always a good thing. But in the meantime, I am just heading to the waypoint. I am 2 miles away from it. Then I'll go to the next steer point. By the way, I hate the fact that this fire extinguisher button is right next to the steer button. If I pull that, that'll cut off the engine. That is something I do not want. So that is a little bit unfortunate, but nothing you can do about it. God, I don't even know what I'm talking about anymore. Today has kind of been a long day. It's been a little bit stressful for personal reasons. I'm alright, but let's just say things have been kind of annoying, to say the least, for the past week. I mean, as I said in my previous video, I am holding off on my Mirage 2000 review because they had an update on it, and honestly, it completely changes the, it completely changes the behavior of the aircraft. It's like flying a new plane now, and, that's kind of weird, to be honest. I don't know why it does that, but I assume that Mirage 2000 was... Okay, no, you're flying. The Mirage 2000 came out incomplete, easily early alpha. I mean, the missiles are terrible, the aerodynamics were unrealistic. I say were, they've been improved quite a bit. But that means it's no longer this mythical dogfighting legend that it used to be, which was honestly its biggest strength. You could not outturn that plane, and you definitely could not outclimb that plane, so if you got into a dogfight with one of those, you'd be pretty screwed if you knew what was going on. That's not to say that the Mirage 2000 doesn't have its advantages. I mean, it's still a very good turner, and it still climbs amazingly. I mean, yes, it's pretty much a wing built around an engine, but I think that's the case for most fighter jets. Obviously, this is not a fighter jet, so it doesn't count. But you kind of get the idea. And I'm going to have a sip of my beer, because why not? I could climb much faster than I'm climbing right now. So, orders from my commanding officer have been kind of weird, because they're telling me that there are only so many bombs that I can put on my plane. Basically, one GBU-12 and one GBU-38. I obviously cheated and said, no, screw you. Yeah, you see that? Beautiful, sexy bombs. I did that. If they get angry at me, well, screw them. I'm pretty sure this will come in handy pretty soon, because I'd rather drop bombs at a distance than deal with things up close, because originally it had, like, one GBU-12, one GBU-38, and a lot of rockets. Okay, I've learned from experience that I will keep getting shot down if I fly too close to the ground. You need to take out AAA first, and it's not just AAA, it's manpads. By the way, I need to turn on my jammer. If they have anything, it's going to be AAA, so I need to jam that. Hopefully that works. Other than that, everything seems to be pretty fine. It's pretty uneventful flight so far, and I don't know if that's going to change. Well, I know it's going to change, I just don't know when. I must admit, the story behind The Enemy Within is so far intriguing, but of course this is all text-based. It's like reading a novel then heading into the mission. It doesn't have any cutscenes. It's a flight simulator. It isn't Ace Combat. But from what I'm hearing, it's very politically intriguing. Basically, these terrorists are in northern Georgia. They're Islamic extremists. Originally, they assume Russia was behind it because they had anti-Western motives instead of anti-Russian motives. But considering that Russia has their own problem with Chechen rebels, that isn't exactly a likely suspect. However, we don't know if it is funded by ISIS or the Taliban or any type of extremist sect or another country. It's kind of been left blank at that point. But it's still a very, very, very interesting concept. And I imagine that it's going to get more interesting as things go on. This is the kind of shit that I'm really into. All this Tom Clancy espionage, figuring out who the enemy really is, figuring out what their motives are. I mean, just awesome. Pure awesome. I should probably turn my landing light off. I reached 10,000 feet way long ago. And I don't even know if the military follows civilian rules when it comes to landing lights, like turn them off above 10,000 feet. I wouldn't be surprised that yes, that is the case, because whenever a military plane leaves military airspace, then they have to answer to air traffic control, the civilian air traffic control. You know, their turf, their rules. Which would make sense, to say the least. So, anyway, moving to the next waypoint, which seems to be not entirely north. I've been running my engines at full throttle the entire flight. I just noticed that. Which is fine. Once I get to altitude, that won't be a problem. And I'm going to get to altitude very quickly. Back on the throttle, and we're good. I mean, isn't exactly 20,000 feet. I'll change that. There we go, now it works. My throttle back quite a bit because I really don't need that much throttle. In fact, I'm still gaining airspeed even though I cut back on the throttle. I love the straight and level cruise flight. Easily the most boring part of a flight, but then again, it allows me to relax. It allows me to appreciate, admire the engines at work. Realizing that I'm 20,000 feet above sea level, and the only reason I'm not suffocating is because I have this oxygen tank at my disposal, which I hope will never run out of oxygen anytime soon. Wink, wink. At least it'll warn me. When it comes to the pre-flight, I almost never, ever, ever use, I never really test anything, any of the enunciator panel or anything like that. I know that in the old A-10C, you used to be able to. Well, what I'm trying to get at is that you used to be able to allow certain system failures at random. I don't think that's the case with this now, but I could be wrong, and hopefully I'm wrong, because that would make things a little bit more interesting. But at this point, I don't have much to talk about, so I'll get back to you when the action occurs.
2 hours later.
Dodge 1-1, overboard.
Jordan Command informed us that one of their checkpoints failed to report in. You're the first air asset we have in the area. Proceed to grid 38, Tango, Lima, November 13723835.
Okay, hang on. Okay. Oh, I really hope that I remember. Is that JTAC? Actually, I'm going to take a picture of this so that I don't screw this up. All right. Let's see. I'm trying to remember how to do this. So, other. Once I figure out how to do this. This. So let's see, it's 38T. All right, and it's Lima. November 13 72. Oh crap, did I? Yeah, okay. Lima, November. Seems like it should have done the trick. Now why is it not showing? T LN 1372. I swear that I got that right. Technical difficulties. Hold on just 1 second.
12 seconds later.
Well, we'll see if this is the correct one. Hope I did that right. There's power lines in a road. Let's see. Is there anything of... Wait, is that smoke? Oh, I think I know what this means. It means that I fucking got it. How about that? I'm happy. Alright. Well, minus the charred corpses, everything seems to be going fine. I know how to navigate, and that's all that matters.
Overlord, Touch 1-1, we are close to the checkpoint. Seems they've been hit hard. We have visual on damaged buildings and some burning vehicles.
God, Overlord. Copy. What about the enemy?
Tally 4 trucks, 1 general mounted CU-23, some infantry in the village to the north. Your west orders.
To the north.
God, wave 1.
I'm guessing this is the, village? I don't see anything, really. Well, we have air defense targets, how about that?
Overlord, dodge copy, engaging target.
Alright, looks like I'm clear to blow them out of the sky, I just don't see where they are.
Contact target, 10 o'clock, point 3.
Where in the fucking ball sack are these guys?
Eventually.
Wait, hold on a second. Ah, there they are! Stupid buffholes. Alright, I finally found them. Took me forever. How about I make the bomb point right there? Then kill them with a GBU-38. Oh, I think that will work just fine. Alright. is a little reticle. A little line for the wonderful reticle of doom. It's gonna take about a minute for this bomb to reach them. But that's fine. They're about to taste some inertially guided freedom. About 20 seconds. Oh, beautiful. Just beautiful. Outside the gimbal limits, I am not naive. Onto something. It's going for another approach. I don't like getting in too close. Rifle. And beautiful shot. I did, and I think that is a AAA as well. I think that is a AAA. Not too entirely sure. Are they dead or taking a nap? I think they're dead. Are these guys dead? This guy not dead. Not dead in the slightest. I'd say they deserve some laser-guided justice. How about you? My lights off. I'll wait just a second. Laser has locked on. And hopefully the proximity of this bomb will take the other guy out as well. this is why I have wingmen.
To engage targets of opportunity.
Two, copy. Two, engaging target.
The question is, should I weasel them? That may not be a good idea. Any AAA fire.
Altitude.
I would have been shot at this point.
To engage targets of opportunity.
Two, copy.
Pull up, pull up. Altitude, altitude. Pull up, pull up.
I wish I didn't lose that target, to be honest.
Pull up, pull up. Pull up, pull up. Altitude, altitude. Pull up, pull up. Pull up. Altitude, altitude. Pull up, pull up. Altitude, altitude. Pull up, pull up.
Wow, the rounds are reaching the other side of the mountain. Wow. That's kind of cool.
Two, running in.
Oh, now you finally do it.
Altitude.
Overlord dodge. Target destroyed.
Nice. Overlord? Hello, Overlord. You copy? You want to not be a complete asshole and answer me? Overlord. Overlord. I guess I go to steer point 4. Wow. It's the only thing I can do.
Dodge, overload. Good job. Continue your patrol.
I still have to continue my patrol? Great. What do I have left? 112 and 138? Alright. Put this on standby so I don't kill myself. Okay, I just dodged a freaking missile and a half. Holy crap, this guy wants me dead. Alright, so I need to rescue a helicopter now. Holy crap. Jesus. Well, no more being nice, he needs to die.
Pull up, pull up. Pull up, pull up.
Just got hit by ground
altitude,
fire.
Altitude, altitude.
Pontiac 1, passing waypoint 14 at 4,000.
Luckily, I think it's just AK fire, so I'm good. I don't see any damage to my systems.
Pontiac 1, pushing from waypoint 15 at 4,500. Lucy, this is Dodge 11, 2810, US Air Force, solid copy. What is your
Alright, well, I think I killed the man pads.
Receive solid copy, set your position, over.
Pontiac 1, pads waypoint 16 at 4,500.
Need to take this guy out. Let's go guns again.
Pull up! Pull up!
So I'm guessing the,
Proceed, Dodge. We have the visual.
Chevy 1, passing waypoint 12 at 4,000.
So I have plenty of guns. I'm gonna go in for another gun run. Just hope that Uzi wasn't killed, because
Chevy Dodge, proceed to landing zone. Area is clear.
I don't know if it's entirely clear, but I need to watch my speed in these mountains. Well, if that doesn't kill them, nothing will. I wasn't going to do this, but no, I won't do labels.
Pontiac 1, in from the east, engaging the utility at bullseye 044 for 30.
Pull up! Pull up!
Pontiac 1, on station at
altitude,
045 for 35 at 6,000. Pontiac 1, kill utility at bull 044 for 30.
Alright. Seems like things are turning out pretty well. think I'll rocket them just in case. Okay, screw it. I'm gonna fly out. Yeah, they're all dead. Hey, it's a legitimate question. And here come the cavalry. I took a few AK rounds for you. Hopefully this pilot is worth it. Well, that's kind of a dark thing to say about allies, but... yeah, I don't think I should comment any further. That was a bad comment, in my opinion. So, apparently, this terrorist situation is a lot more dire than what you'd expect. Of course, I am not surprised in the slightest. I just hope to God, you know, knock on wood. Seriously, knock on wood that this game doesn't crash on me. Otherwise, it's gonna be pretty strenuous, but if it does crash, then I will pick up where I left off, and I will continue the Let's Play. All for you, because you guys are awesome. Very curious, where are the helicopters? Well, I can return to base, how nice, because I am... I don't need those bombs anymore. What does that mean? That means that, crap, my CO was right. I only needed those two bombs. Someone's in trouble. Oh well. So be it. The F-35 could suck it.